Hello and welcome to my newest workshop. In this special workshop, we are going to learn the most easiest skill ever that will give you the possibility to make everything you like with your knitting machine, with your circular knitting machine. We are going to learn how to make hats with vertical stripes. This hat is 52 stitches wide. Don't go away, because you don't need a machine that wide. It doesn't exist. You know, 48 is the maximum width of a circular knitting machine, but this hat is wider, so it will fit the biggest guy of the world. But we also learn how to knit small tubes, real small tubes. They're good for making dolls, and you see there is no seam, so they're perfect for everything. But you can also make pen tubes very wide. We are going to learn how to make a hat like this. We are going to learn how to make a multi color panel. We are going to learn how to make pieces like this with just one simple skill. Watch this whole video, and I assume you joined my free workshops that I posted before, so now you know how easy it is to play with your machine and knit everything flat and panel. You have seen my easy peasy multi-use flat panel video that I used for this one. When you haven't seen, check in the description. I put all the links to the videos. I am Dutch, so excuse me for my language mistakes and stuttering and stuff, but I want to share this because I'm learning this to people in my country for over 10 years now. So stay tuned, make yourself a cup of coffee or tea, and watch this video so you can make everything you like in the future. It's just one simple skill, I promise. When you have seen my formal workshops about knitting I-cords and flat panels in different shapes, you know how easy that is. That's just as easy as knitting in the round. The secret is that these are made of flat panels, but joined so easy that you will laugh when I show you the secret. I know you are curious about this one. Tubes are joined with an invisible seam. You can see it's an invisible seam. It works just like, if it looks just like it's knitted in the round. And now I'm going to show you the big secret. Do not mind all of those ends, because this is just an example. Are you ready? I will only do this once. See, I have a blue thread here. I just pulled it out. You saw how easy it is? It's just as easy to create this. And then, look, it's a flat panel. And now you're still curious. Have you seen that I used a blue piece of yarn and that you did not see it? About a invisible seam. This was a tube that was made from four panels. Four panels, one white, red, blue, just color change. One red, one white, and one red, white, red. Just color change. And then I've joined them, and that's really easy. I'm going to show you. And this invisible seam gives a rich. You have to be aware that you think about each project, what kind of seaming you want. If you want to have an invisible seam, you will always have a ridge. It's not possible to make it invisible on both sides. So that's about making a tube from flat panels. I am going to show you. You can make so a tube as wide as you want. I'm going to show you a pattern for a hat. I am going to make as an example to you. Designing a reversible hat. That's what we are talking about here. I want a reversible hat that's bigger than the one that I make on my Eddy King size 46 stitches machine. My cat is joining and really distracting. Okay, knitting a hat. I want to make a hat a little bit bigger than the maximum of my Eddy King size 46 machine. So I knit a flat panel, wide 43 stitches, and I knit 40 rows wide, 40 rows red, and 40 rows wide. So this is Pimmetje. And then I knit a panel, a black panel, and I knit it at least 120 rows, because that's as long as this is. And I knit a few extra, because I miscount, or my counter miscounts or something, so I can correct it. And I do not use a to cast off. I use scrap yarn. That's important, otherwise you cannot make it shorter. And the panel I made 12 stitches wide. I've got my two pieces. And I am going to start the joining at the beginning. So this is the cast on. You put the two panels with the wrong side together. Wrong sides together. Then you search for your first stitch and you put your needle with your yarn. I'm going to do this with this bright pink yarn so you can see very good, and with a green needle, how it works. Then you are going to catch the last stitch from the other side. That's a little bit. And you just pull through the yarn, and then I am going to show you something, maybe another color. Let's see this one. Okay, when you knit flat, I always say that you have to give a little tug to the at the end, and that will create a nice edge. That edge, it looks like it has stitches. That's correct. But what are we going to do? When you pull, you see all those rail tracks. Yes? You are going to find the first one, and you can find that easy by, this is the first stitch. This is the side. It's the first track next to the side. You just put your needle under those two bars of that track. And then you take the opposite side, and there you are going to find also that first track. This is the first stitch, so you find those two first. Here they are. It's very handy to use black. So now you have those two on your needle, and then you just pull through. And now comes, don't pull it very tight, keep it open, we can make it tight later on. Then we ended at this side. We just stick our needle in where it came out, underneath the next two bars. Pull through. Then on the opposite side, you go in the same hole where your yarn came out, under two bars. Those holes are very big, so, and then you continue on the other side. You always go in where you came out. See, it looks like it's not the same, but it is really the same hole. Under two bars, and then you go to the other side, go in where you came out, under two bars. It's just simply lacing. And when you get you get the track and the hang on it, you just lace as easy as that you knit circular. It will take you a little bit more time, but you can make such a wonderful designs, and you do not have to know more than how to put your yarn into a yarn needle. Just under those two bars. Sometimes you have to search, and you can see that this is your side stitch. Always go in where you came out. Always go in where you came out. And then you can just continue. And then when you pull the yarn on both sides, hup, 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 barbaar truc. It's joined. You can see slightly through the pink yarn, but you will always use or black or white. You will always use the color of one of your tubes. And when I was making this one, I joined with white because it was white connecting, so there will not be a red one. This one was joined with, I don't know, red or white. And this one was joined with, guess what? Red, because it was joining to red. That there is red on the white parts, that doesn't matter, but that's connecting red. But white in the middle of here, and when you stretch it, you can see it. Just as you can see it, like this. See? And when you're out of track, you simply start over. Just pull. This is how you lace simply a easy seam. I will show you how you finish your hat when you are using panels. I'll be back in a moment. So. Now I'm almost finished. I see a lot of opportunities, do you? This took me about 10 minutes, one side and the other side. This is the last part. And while I was doing this on the couch, I was thinking that I had to tell you something more about it. So this is really easy, except when you're using black on video, but it's just simply lacing. Here you come out. Oh, here you come out, you go in. Here you come out, you go in. Here you come out. You go in. I always use two bars, but when you're lacing something like those little blocks, you want them to match, of course. you can count and you can see if it will match. If it's not matching, you can just smuggle. Yay, you're allowed to smuggle. And then you do, instead of two bars, one bar. And that's the simply way to match it. When you're making a multicolor hat or something that you want to close, you better cast on and off with some scrap yarn. So as here, I will show you why in a minute when I finished this part. I made this a lot longer, but it only has to be this much longer because you want that everything fits to each other. And this is a way too long now, but that's not a problem. So. Just pushing and pulling. So now I have a tube that's wider than normal. And I want to close it as we are used to when we are making a hat. When you have a lot of different colors, you use scrap yarn and then you take a new strand. Let's take the pink one again. And the needle. And then before closing, you are going to pick up all the stitches on one piece of yarn. And when you have done that, I just make a quick step now. And every stitch is secured with your new yarn. You can just easily pull out your scrap yarn. And then you can continue closing your hat as you're used to. But now I only have two pieces. So I'm going to close my hat as I am used to, just by pulling one of the longest of the two threads. Just as we are used to. And when you have pulled one of the two closed, then you search for the other end. Where the heck is it? Oh, no, that's not. Oh, yeah, I found it. And see, this one belongs to the inside. This one still on the ball of yarn. You can just pull the threads on the inside. The ones that you're not using to finish. And as you see, oh, this one is also still, you can just close them as you're used to. As you are used to, me, I just put in the threads after knotting them. But you can do it whatever you like. And then the other side, where I am going to finish with that long part. I did not use scrap yarn, I just rip it. Oh, no. Frog it, rip it, rip it, rip it, rip it, rip it, rip it. Okay. Not until you are at the point where you have to finish, but I will speed up it a little bit. And then you simply search your finishing yarn of the other color. In this case, it's just the white one. Be sure you pick the one you use to close it down. And then you simply wait till your stitches are at the same row, and then just catch them so, and now you can just by pulling your yarn, all the threads you do not need, you just put it inside. For instance, that's the way I do it. Okay, normally I am knotting them and stuff like that, to be sure that everything is going to be okay. But for now, it's just a sample. It's to inspire you. It's not a hat I'm going to sell. Always be sure that your knitting is neatly arranged. My needle. Closing as I am used to. And then, just like each hat, you can variate whatever you like with different colors, because now we've got a reversible hat that's the same on both sides, but that's that. So let's jump over to connected corner pieces, other forms. Sometimes you just want a flat seam. You see that practice makes progress. When I started, it was dramatic, and now it's very neat. So don't give up. Practice makes progress, and this is really a simple skill that will help you to make a lot of nice projects. Joining those sides, this is longer than a straight side, but that doesn't matter. That will give it shape, and you always join row to row. And to get a flat seam, you need to work as much as possible at the corner. Now, we start again with just joining the first two stitches. And what are we going to do now? when you look up some tutorials, they tell you about all the strange things. The principle in what we have to do is just join in the same way. You see here, this is the edge stitch. It looks like it has a vertical bar, but you see you will not see that constantly. So just pick a stitch you like and that you can see all the way coming. And then you just pick that up, and then you pick up a stitch on the other side, and then you pick up the same stitch on this side as you did the first one. And then I go to the other side, and that's this one. And then I find the same stitch, and that should be this one. And then I go to the other side. And this is how you seam a flat seam. The green yarn is the yarn that I use. This is going to be the seam in a flat way. Of course, you use or the purple one or the pink one. In this piece, I would use a purple one because I'm also connecting to the green one. And you take the yarn from the color you've got the most of. So you just keep on joining the stitches repeatedly in the same way. When you make a little mistake, nothing on the hand. That's Dutch. It really doesn't make a big difference if you make a mistake. This is handcraft. I shall tell you a story. I sold a couple of years hats and things. And on Queen's Day in my country, then we have one big flea market and we can sell whatever we like except food. And then I will, and that goes on day and night. So it's 24 hours fun in Holland. And when I sell stuff, people are then always saying to crochet things, oh, that's nice knitted. And to knitted things, oh, that's nice crochet. People will not notice differences in tension. People will not notice little mistakes. People who did not make it will not look as critical as you. So put your personal criticus into the closet and just continue doing what you do. Make yourself a few pieces just for practice. Practice knitting flat panels, practice joining the pieces, and you will have lots of fun. See, I was talking, so here I made a mistake, but you've got the idea. Just continue the same way and it's okay. That's about a flat seam. This is going to be a pillowcase or a barrette or a blanket or a coaster. You can use it for everything. What have I made? I made triangles with one straight side and one, I don't know. I made triangles, this one. I made 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, the same ones. Of course, I started at the point and then I made them as wide as possible on my 22 needle machine. These are made on the 22 needle machine, but imagine that you have a 46 needle machine, or that you make more pointy pieces and then you can make them as long as you like by just increasing every other row. These are increase every each row. So
make yourself some some pieces to practice. This is joined with a flat seam, just because it's possible. You see that my progress continues. These are really nice flat seams. But for a pillow, that's of course not necessarily. But I did it because I want to use the full width of those triangles I made. But you can also make this with the ridge. Maybe you have to make another piece then. You can play with the amount of pieces, because you can make different shapes. When you add more pieces, it will be a real round ball shape. So, flat joining or joining with a ridge, it's just simply lacing, and you can make all kinds of projects now. So let your fantasy work, and just draw something, knit it. When you do not like it, rip it out, frog it, rip it out, start over. It does not cost you a lot of time. Enjoy crafting. Make sure you enjoy your machine to the max. There is so much possible. You will find at my channel all kind of free workshops. Join my channel if you like them, and give me a thumb up if you are glad that you saw this video. Stay safe, keep on crafting, and lots of love from Holland. I see you at my next workshop. Have a nice day.